Hey, everything is working perfectly well. Please tell me, where have you seen or heard a man give a girl so much gifts and money, a girl he hasn't even had sex with? I die here. Wallahi, Kai, I'm so glad I accepted to date this man. The rich are old man, you can't say that again. What kind of talk is that one now? See, don't let me slap you through this phone. Me, marry that old man. Catch me. You got to ask questions well now. I cannot marry that kind of old man now. God forbid. Man, I will become so old that I'll have to start carrying him all around after using the toilet. I can't live that kind of life, I beg. You know me. I'm just here for the fun. When I, Katrina, be done with that man. With the wind, I'm off. You haven't seen anything. Do you know what? We'll continue this just later. Let me go and just touch his head, rub his body. I need more money now. You don't know how it is.
Your rice, should I serve it with stew or vegetable sauce?
I'm not hungry.
Sir, please, you need to eat something, please.
Oloma, leave me alone. I said leave me alone, please.
Sir, no matter how much your heart grieves, your body still needs food, or you stand the risk of falling sick. Please.
Oloma, you are the reason I am in this predicament right now. I was fine and dandy until you suggested I start looking for this so-called love. And see where it landed me. You should have left me the way I was.
I'm sorry, sir. But, sir, I've been with you ever since I was 8. I was just 8 years old when you employed my mother. And you have been nothing but good to me. Which is why all I want is your happiness.
My happiness? Yet you introduce someone who was only interested in my words and not me. Do you know how I feel right now? Eh? Do you?
I'm sorry, sir. But, sir, before your wife died, you promised her that you won't stop living. And knowing Madame as much as I did, she would have given the same advice that I am giving now. You don't have to stop looking for love. If you stop now, that would mean you're breaking the promise you made to her. And to my late mother too. You promised both of them that you won't stop living, no matter what.
Who is that? Who is that now? Allow me to come. Are you done off the gate? Yes. Banku. Okay, good. Madam, come back here. What is your problem? I told you to wait till I call you. That is when I have the money for you to make your hair.
Stop talking like a poor man, I beg. Does this hair look like what your salary can afford?
Swagger. Swagger, Biakwa. Come here. Now, tell me this man that has decided to sign his death warrant for I, Swaggy Shaw Sonazi, is the right person to help you fulfill his desire to die. That is today.
Believe my hand. Leave me alone. So you think that I, Banku, will still go after a poor man like you again in this life? Never! It will not happen.
This is a serious case. Now, Banku, listen to me attentively. Tell me this man that gave you this money now. Else, two things will happen.
Eh?
It's either your hair is removed or your head will roll.
This is where you are very stupid, Onazi.
Me, stupid?
Yes, because it is only a stupid man that would think that a woman will have to go to a man before she can get anything for herself.
So what did he do?
Eh! Stop pouring saliva on me. Look, leave the way. Let me do what I came here to do.
Come on, come back here. Hey! Swag, Swag, something have happened.
Hey!
Oh! So you are now a full-fledged legged girl. Look at how you're even posing your two left legs in front of me. Eh, hey, you can now come and pass. You can now come and pass. Abi, you are going inside. Who are you? Have you forgotten when I met you? When I picked you up, you are just tying rapper. Not just the original rapper or rapper. And I'll be like, and you come. Now I have discovered your physical talents and your natural appearance. Eh? Who does you watch? Oh, is even a fake one? It's even very good. Oh, see you long man. Devilish. Ha! Swaggy, I finished. Now, let me ask you. Banku, are you like out of your sense?
No, my guy. I have actually regained my senses. And I have upgraded above your level. I came here to see your boss. And not you.
My boss.
So,
my God. God please don't allow it to happen to Swaggy. You mean my boss?
Yes, your boss. If it is easy, go and make money.
Swaggy coaching. What do I do now?
About what, sir?
You know what I'm talking about. Before I dated Catherine, my heart was practically dead to romance and anything relating to love. But she awoke in it and now fireballs inside my heart.
Sir, you're a very good man. And I have no doubt in my heart that very soon you'll find a woman who will love you for you.
In today's world, come on, Onoma. You and I know that the women of these days, all they know is money. Money, more money, and more money. Love is practically dead out there.
No, sir. Love is not dead. And true love never dies. Trust me on that one.
Okay. So, what do you suggest I do now? Because honestly, I am at my wit's end right here.
Sir.
Yes?
I think you show your hand to the ladies too much.
How do you mean?
You make it very difficult for yourself to actually know if they love you for you because of how you spend money on them. Maybe you need to take up a new character or start acting like a poor man.
Excuse me? Me acting like a poor man?
Yes, sir. I think you should bring yourself several levels down from where you actually are. And any woman who would love a man who doesn't have money must truly love him for who he is.
Hi, Banku. So you are going inside? To meet who? My boss.
your boss is searching for love, and I am here with love all over me. Eh? More than enough to share with him. Hey. Leave me alone.
Okay. So I can now and see where the problem is. Ha! So I go gonna. I told you that my boss is looking for love. I'm not Tokumbo love. My boss seriously wants a tier ladder first class girl, not Bendan Select like you.
Hey!
Wait, now let me tell you something. Eh? You see, my boss is a big man. And he always goes for the highest thing, the best thing in life. Look at you. If you're a clothes, you are Bendan Select. Yes. You are too poor, and you are still as poor as church rats. Forget this attire. You are meant to roll with niggas like me. So I go again. You understand the security officer? Eh? Else, we are to be walking in our abject poverty, flowing happily. Eh?
God forbid. God forbid, Onazi, that I will go after, or rather, continue following a poor guy like you in this life. God forbid.
Madam Maswa, you've heard it. That means you're mad. Hmm? So you don't want to work with me again?
It's you that is mad.
You have overstayed your welcome.
How?
Ona.
Atahayowa. Shock.
Hello. Baby.
Johnson.
Ha! You're looking so splendid.
Were you smoking just now?
Me.
You were not smoking. Johnson, why are you doing this to me now? Why? You told me you stopped smoking.
Maybe I'm sorry, okay? She doesn't know I smoke. Sometimes I feel useless.
Why would you even say a thing like that? Why would you feel useless when you have somebody like me in your life? Am I not trying? I'm doing everything I can to help you. Why are you doing this to me?
You don't understand. I'm a man. For how long? For how long would you continue to take care of us? Look at me. I don't have money. I don't have I have nothing.
Johnson, I'm not complaining now. I'll keep doing the best I can for us. Eh? Oh, so you want to keep smoking and die and leave me alone? Oh, why will I find a man that will love me the way you love me?
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. All right, forgive me. I'm sorry.
Okay, you are forgiven.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand? What is it now?
What is it?
Why are you crying now? There are people around you. Justine, please, no. Okay, is it because I shouted? I'm sorry. Stop now. I'm crying. Okay, if you don't stop, I'm not going to tell you why I came here. You want to cry, cry.
It's okay.
Have you stopped?
I have stopped.
Okay. I came to tell you that my boss gave me bonus money for the weekend. So, I brought some for you. So, you can use to buy whatever you want to buy.
What a bonje! You know, that's why I love you, baby. Thank you. You are truly God sent, baby.
I know.
Yeah. You know, I love your pink alarm. You know what?
We have to start going so that you can change it. Understand?
Shakum!
Said you should hurry up with the cleaning of the car. You have to take him to the island for a meeting.
Is that why you are frowning your face? Is that why you are keeping your face like that? I'm almost through. I'm done, sir.
Hello, ma. Ah, thank God you are here. You see, I came to meet.
Banku, Jesus, what are you doing here? Why do you want to get me fired?
Leave her alone. What is it?
Thank you, my sweet sister. You see, I came to see you. And as he told me that your boss is searching for a wife. And that he broke up with his ex-girlfriend just because she was lying to him in order to collect money. I felt really pained in my heart too, because Chief is a very nice man. And I've come to help him, oh.
See, is it a liar?
So, how do you plan to help him?
Simple, very simple. I want to marry him and shower him with love. When I mean love, correct love, oh. I will finish his life with love. And as for you, Oloma, you know you don't know how to cook. It's only local dishes that you know how to prepare. All these things you are hearing, I don't understand. I don't know if you are going to dance. Because by the time I enter this house as your madam, it is only intercontinental dishes that I will be eating. And I know you don't know how to prepare. You talk more of knowing the name. The best thing I will do is to go and put you in one catering school where you will learn how to prepare professional meals for I and my husband. Then for this one here, I'm going to send you to your village. In fact, I'll be the one to give you transport back to your village. Because I am going to employ a well-trained driver and security guard. I don't want problem, bro.
Is that all?
That's not all, though. Ha. Other benefits will be attached to it now and then, you know?
Nah, it's okay. Onazi.
Ma?
You know if Chief comes out and meets her here, you're in serious trouble.
I'm come.
Oh, no, am I just leaving like that? So you will not say anything? Just shut up your mouth. Just shut up.
Anyway, no problems. Babankus, can you help me with the name of your village? I want to know the location.
What for?
So that I know where I will deposit your body when I must have killed you. Oh, why am I even looking for where to deposit your body? There is this canal down there. By the time I'm done cutting your body into pieces, I will now deposit it there. So meanwhile, let's start from the name. Thank you. Bring it. Anofia. Idiot! So you have to come and sack me. Look at this local version. You are an idiot for employing this idiot.
Oga. Yes, sir. Oga, beg him money, my take shop. Hungry, they beat me. Oga, beg.
Come on, get your place. Which one be giving money?
Oga, beg.
At your age and your size, you don't know where to go and fight for money.
Come down and find one. You are looking for who to receive. Yeah, my man! Yeah!
Oh, shit. What is your problem?
I'll bust your head now. Oga. Why you go say you go boss my head? You match me, never talk sorry. Say you go boss my head. Because I only a bit to come and come back money. Say you go match my head.
Sadishan is a liar.
It's alright. There's no need for your ruckus. Let me get you some money.
I'm sure.
Please don't give him any money. Money. I know this man. Oh yeah. Leave this place now.
Oga, who be this one now? Oga, who be this
not
one?
You want to beg money for here every day. If you don't leave this place by the time I open my eyes, I am going to call the police and I will make sure that you sleep in that cell tonight. Let me see how you're going to get money to eat. Oh, yeah, leave this place.
If they don't tell the truth, I will tell the truth. If you winch, that's for my market. If you winch, call police now.
Nonsense. Please leave this place.
Nothing is wrong with him. Oh, my head high blood.
So, what was that all about?
I don't mind him. It's just some riffraff that's always walking around trying to dupe people. He's a criminal, honestly. Wow. So sorry about that. I hope you're okay.
It's okay. I'm fine. Right. My name is Jacob.
Michaela. Nice to meet you.
Michaela. What a beautiful name.
Please
forgive my parents. Can I take you out and buy you something?
Oh, no. That won't be necessary. I'm actually on my way back to the office now. My lunch break is over, so it's fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
In that case, let's drop you off at your office before going back to our office.
Okay, if you insist.
All right. Let's drop this lady at our office before going back to our own office. Before Oga will notice that we are not back yet.
Oga?
Yes, Oga.
Okay.
All right.
Please. Ooh! Happy Eagle!
Welcome, sir. Welcome, sir.
Look, I found the one.
Sir?
Found the one.
The one, sir?
Yes, the one.
What are you talking about, sir?
Look, I'm talking about the most beautiful woman that God ever created. Look, her name is Michaela. She is exquisite both in gifts and character.
Oh, sir, you found a woman you like.
God sent a special angel in the likeness of a lady into my life today, and I am most gracious unto him for his mercies.
Sorry, sir. You met her today?
Yes, I will talk for about 3 hours. And guess what? I made her believe I worked for the boss that owned the car I was in, and I pretended that Onazi was going to report me to my boss, and I was ready to risk all that just to be with her, and it worked like magic.
What worked, sir?
Everything. And I think she likes me too.
Wow. So Woo! Fast.
Yes, look, you know what? She was all into me, and I could feel it by the way she likes my jokes. And she brushed against my body when I walked out to the door of her house.
Sir, you went to her house?
Yes. And you know what? When I dropped her at her house, I pretended to have received a call from my angry boss at the office. And look, everything was so perfect. And I could feel it right in my bones, in my spirit, and in my marrow.
Sir. You need to take this thing easy. You know how it ended with Catherine, and we wouldn't want you to go through another heartbreak.
There is no but at all. Onoma, look, Michaela is the woman I want in my life. And I've already started just like you advised. You see, I told her that I am poor and she doesn't mind at all. And look, I feel so good.
Woo! I feel good. Ha la 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 la. Ooh, ooh, ooh. La 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 la. Ooh. I feel good. La 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 la. Ooh. Ooh. I feel good. La 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 la.
Help me and wonder man. You should not step his foot inside that handle. That is the only thing remaining for me. Yeah? Tell him that I'm a swag boy in town, and if I should enter village, I will borrow all the money I have, and I will make sure you go hear that case. Get it out. What is the problem with him?
Onazi.
Yeah? Meanwhile, I'm coming. I'm coming. Thank you.
I want to know what happened between Oga and the lady he met today. Just tell me everything.
Is it Oga and the lady?
You see, Oga met a woman today when we went to an eatery to pick her snacks. Huh? They hit it off. They hit it off like fire. In fact, with the way they were mingling and romancing and moving around, it reminded me of Romeo and Juliet.
What is your problem? I just asked you a simple question, very simple question, and you are going back and forth without even saying anything.
What is your problem? Eh? What is your problem? Why are you even talking to me as if I'm a child?
Why would I talk to you as a child? I asked you a simple question, and you're going back and forth, beating about the bush. Just tell me what I want to know.
Aroma, I am telling you nothing. You see, I had enough tough day driving Oga and his new friend. So don't come out of the injury. Do you get it? So I'm telling you nothing, and leave me alone. Swag Oga, swag Kato. What is it, Biko?
Oh, Nazi. Your blood is always too hot. I just want to know what happened between Oga and the lady. That's all.
Maroma, I said I'm telling you nothing. And I'm not going to tell you anything. Do you get it now? So you better give yourself the space of going inside to rest. What is even your own? All the time they say anything concerning Oga, you always carry the matter on your head as if... Are you his wife? Are you his wife? I'm asking you.
Oh, Nazi. Okay. Have you eaten anything today?
No. But see, I don't want any cold something to come and hit my stomach. You get it? So if you are getting me anything, you make it hot. I mean very, very hot.
No problem. Since you want to show me that you are stubborn, you know that Mama Put by the mechanic workshop? I know you used to go there now, that Mama Put. That's where you're going to buy all the food you will eat today.
Eh? I didn't hear you were.
I cooked though, but you see me, I will not give you any food. Go and buy Mama Put.
Ale, cooks olives. Is he always like the shakara just because he know you are the one having our stomach under your department? Eh? You see, for this little threat now. Don't threat me again, no. But ask me anything you want to know about that woman, and I will tell you all without keeping nothing. I tell you, it's a promise from Swag.
Sit down.
Oh, no, I'm fine, sir. I'll stand.
Okay. I have this great idea of how we can determine whether Michaela is the woman for me or not.
Sir, don't you think it's too early for this discussion? I mean, I should be making breakfast.
Aloma.
Sir?
I think that breakfast can wait. This is a very important thing. I mean, we need to know whether Michaela is the real deal or not.
Okay, I'm all ears, sir.
All right. I've thought about this all night, and I finally realized that this is the best idea we can, you know, come up with. You remember I already told Michaela that I have a boss?
Yes, sir.
Good. I want us to hire someone who will come here and live with us. And he'll be acting like my boss. And he'll be brandishing money here and there. And Michaela will be coming here and be seeing all that. So if at the end of the day, Michaela follows him, I know that she's not the woman for me. But if she remains for me, then I know she's the real deal. What do you think?
Sir, I think this plan is rather too elaborate and too stressful.
Don't worry yourself about all that. I know love is everywhere. But I also know that true love is very hard to find. So I am going to do everything possible, even if it means bringing out my love out of a hole to have a second chance at true love.
Sir, when I suggested you act poor, I didn't think you would go this length just to find love.
Aloma, look, don't worry your head. You need to understand that I'm a successful businessman. And my sixth sense has always been the joker. So I will employ Sim in this case. And you'll see how fantastic it will go.
Okay, sir. Can I go and make breakfast for you now?
No. I need you to suggest to me someone you think is a very good actor who will come and act as my boss here in this house. Do you have any idea?
See, Onazi, I've told you this thing before. You need to go back to your village and beg your village people to get off your case. Because the way it's leading you, next thing, madness will.
Come. What has my village people gotten to do with you slapping me up? You just slap me up and I call my village people.
Your village people have got everything to do with it. How can you be sleeping at the duty post and be thinking of something that even your 10th generation, you cannot achieve? Someone you will never see in your life.
Swago. Hey! Do you see why I said it's your village people that have been following you around? Because if not for them, you wouldn't come and slap me up. Now, number one, The dream is my dream. The sleep is also mine. Oh, Roma, why can't you allow me to rest in peace? Don't laugh. It's not like rest in peace as R.I.P.O. It's just rest in peace as rest peacefully.
And I was just about to say amen.
Yeah? Oloma, now tell me, what do you want?
Hey! Look, Onazi. There's about to be a big problem in this household. A big problem that will chase you and me out of this house.
What happened?
What happened? It's about this new girl Chief met now, Michaela. He has been going on and on about Michaela, Michaela. What is it?
Oloma, I don't understand. What do you even mean? What about the girl now?
You don't understand. Look, since we woke up, Chief has been talking about this girl. Michaela, Michaela, what is it?
Oloma, do you know we've been here for over some minutes since you woke me up from my sleep? And yet I'm to understand you. What is your wahala? What is your problem now? What is the problem with the girl?
Onazi, I've always known that you don't have sense. But let me just continue managing you as I've been doing. I am a woman. Are you listening to me? I'm a woman. And with the way Chief is going on about this girl, it's not a good thing. No? Chief is just acting like somebody that has not seen a woman before. Look, this kind of power, if it's in the hands of a bad woman, it can be very disastrous.
Okay. Is it not too early for us to start thinking about this girl this way? After all, we just met her yesterday. And eventually, you might not stand the opportunity of meeting her anywhere again in life.
See this one. You think it's too early? This Chief that I've been listening to. I even had to run outside because I'm tired of hearing him talk about her. What is it?
It's as serious as that.
Well, I don't want you to take him to go see her anymore.
Jesus. Who sent you? Hey, God. Oh, yeah. Clap for yourself. Clap for yourself. Or jump up. Rather. Come. I hope you have other works waiting for me by the time Chief will kick me out of this place for not doing what he asked me to do.
Calm down, I beg. That's not how it's going to work. We'll just look for a distraction, you know, find someone that will take his mind off this girl.
I still don't understand you. Meanwhile, who would that person be? Mark the day I will commit my first murder. First murder. Fire!
Come. Don't kill anybody.
Because I'm going to open this gate now. Break down this ghetto.
I will commit murder now.
No, you will not kill anybody. I won't.
But something.
Yeah, my lady. Well, baby, don't worry. By next week, I will send you some money. So you will enjoy yourself. I mean, daddy will arrange some party for us. You understand? My love, don't worry. I hope you'll be sending, will you be coming? All right, so no problem. Okay. All right, ma. Okay, mommy. Mommy, don't worry. As I was saying, you see, so sorry, Don't worry, I will soon find a job. Okay, ma. Don't worry, I will send you the money. Thank you. All right. Bye.
How is she?
She's fine, She's fine. You always, worry me. Money.
Don't worry. She'll be fine.
Always looking so splendid.
Thank you.
My pumpkin.
Where are you going to?
Do you know my friend Akim?
Yes.
Akim was telling me that there was this job at a factory. They need people. Yeah, so he was calling me to come check it out.
That's good now.
Yeah.
But how would you like to be an actor? Or how would you like to work as an actor?
Actor,
yes. Movie actor now.
For that. Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious now.
Don't make me laugh.
acting. Ah, I don't know acting. Besides, who in his right senses will hire?
My boss will hire you. Don't worry. Just leave every other thing to me. He will hire you.
Are you serious?
I'm serious now.
Anazia, I don't trust you. I don't trust you one bit at all. I just had to tell you now. I don't trust you.
Shut up. Close that stupid gutter. Yeah? I should be the one suspicious of you. Because from the first day I met you and I started dating you, you've given me nothing but one problem.